Have you ever solved a tanker voyage estimate question? It is something similar to what we did in a dry cargo, but this time we'll be looking into the tanker segment. So let's see now this. Hey, what's up? My name is Akash from Shipsco, bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. In the Chartering 101 series, guys, we have seen the basics of chartering, we have seen the dry cargo chartering, and now we are into the tanker one. This is going to be the last lecture for the tanker series, in which we are going to focus upon the voyage estimate question. If you're new here, consider subscribing it at any point of the time. Also, check out the notes and links in the description below. And guys, if you want to have the slides, you can always go to my website, get it downloaded. The whole package consists of the comprehensive lecture notes which we are covering right now. It consists of past papers, ICS papers, the SOLD ICS papers, and my own lecture notes, which will enable you to understand this subject very well. So, what are you waiting for? Let's go for this. Hi guys, welcome to Chartering 101 by Shipsco. So in today's lecture number 30, we'll be looking into the tanker voyage estimate question. First, we'll look what are the elements, and then we'll be directly diving into the question. So what are the elements of the voyage estimate form? Cargo carrying capacity of a ship, vessel specification, speed, freight rate, the length of the voyage and routes, port time and port cost, lay time and demurrage, bunker consumption, the price and the quantity of bunkers remaining on board at the commencement of the voyage and any replenishment en route. Commission. These figures combined in the estimate give the owner the daily surplus, which is the yardstick for the comparison of the voyage on offer. So now let's look into the question now. Before we proceed into this question, I would like you guys to have your calculators ready, pen and paper, and your phone so that you can take a snapshot of the question. Now we have VLCC MT Athena. The summer deadweight is 273,000 deadweight tons. Speed is 12.5 knots in loaded condition, and in ballast condition it can make 13 knots. Consumption. It consumes 62 tons per day in loaded and in ballast. Consumption for DO in port when the vessel is idle, it will consume 24 tons per day, but when it's working, it will consume 38 tons per day diesel oil. The constants are 450 metric ton. Fixture. Assume 248,000 metric ton of cargo. Load port is Ras Tanura. Discharge port is London. So the first loaded leg will be from Ras Tanura to London via Cape and return via the Suez Canal. Distances from Ras Tanura to London is 11246 nautical miles. From London to Ras Tanura is 6416 nautical miles. Port time. The total 4 days. That means 2 days for discharging and 2 days for loading. Suez Canal transit is 1 day. Consumption of 20 tons of fuel oil. The canal transit southbound in ballast. Price for that is $260,000. The port costs are $70,000 at load port and $180,000 at the discharge port. With this, I would like you to take a snapshot of this slide. Other details. Address and brokerage commission is in total is 2.5%. The bunker price is $260 per ton for fuel oil and $400 per ton for diesel oil. Running costs for the vessel per day is $10,000 per day. War risk additional premium. The insured value is 70 million and the applicable war risk additional premium for Ras Tanura is 0.03% of that 70 million. Crew war bonus insurance is $4,000. The flat rate. As we studied full scale in now in this, the flat rate Ras Tanura to London to from the Cape is 20.25 per metric ton. Fixture agreed at WS80. This is on the fixture which is fixed on US 0.23 per tons to be added
has fixed rate differential on cargo loaded or discharged in London. So there is a fixed rate differential which is we are supposed to add it. Assumption, no load line zone or draft restrictions at any point, no safety margin required. No dispatch money are payable in tanker charter parties as we have studied in our previous lectures. Calculate the net freight, net daily revenue and time charter rate. This is what the whole question is. This is the second snap you can take. Let's go ahead. So the first loaded leg will look like this. We start from Rustenura. We go from here, Arabian Sea. We go down. There's the Cape of Good Hope. From there, we just go up. And finally, reaching towards the London. The ballast leg, in order to come back again, this time our VLCC is going to go from the Mediterranean to Suez. We have the Mediterranean Sea, Suez, and then it goes back again. So this is the second leg, which is your ballast leg. So our vessel name is motor tanker Athena. The loading speed is, as per the question, is 12.5 knots. Ballast speed is given as 30 knots. In each day, at this speed, the vessel can cover 300 nautical miles. Whether in, when it ballast, it can cover 312 nautical miles in a day. As far as the daily bunker consumption is concerned, at sea, the fuel oil consumed is 62 tons. No diesel oil. When in port, in idle condition, the diesel oil consumption is 24. And when in working, it's 38. The first leg is from Rustenura to London via the Cape of Good Hope. And it's in loaded condition. The total amount of distance given as per the question is 11246 nautical miles. If you divide this by 300, you'll get 38 days. When you multiply this 38 with the fuel oil, you get this amount of consumption per day. The second leg is from the London to Rustenura in ballast condition. We have been given 6416 as the distance. If you divide this by 312, you'll get total days to be 21. When you multiply 21 with 62, you get fuel oil figures as 1302 tons of consumption. We didn't have any bunkering port in this question. We do have a canal transit, which we are supposed to take just one day, in which we'll be consuming excess 20 tons of the fuel oil. We don't have any adverse weather allowance. Port time is given as, for loading port it is 2 days and discharge it is 2 days. In total there are 4 days. Now, how did you get this figure 124 total? So if you see, as we know guys, in tankers, the ship remains idle when it's loading. But when it's discharging, it's using its own bunkers. That is why the idle tons is lesser than the working diesel oil. When you multiply 24 by 2, you get 48. And 2 multiplied by 38, you get 76. So in total, we have 64 days. And fuel oil consumption in total is 3678 in total. For diesel oil, it's 124. Now let's have a calculation for DWCC. What is the cargo carrying capacity? As per the question given, the total deadweight is 273,000. Now the bunkers, 3754 is available. How did we arrive at this figure? When you add 2356 plus 1302 plus 20 plus just the 76, which is at discharging, we get the figures for bunkers as 3754. And as per the question is given, which is constant, we get 450. When you subtract these total, which is 4204 by 273,000, we get our cargo carrying capacity as 268,796. But we have already been given the question that we are supposed to take 248,000, as we'll see ahead. Now, we have already calculated how much bunkers are being consumed. All we need to do is to find the total bunker cost. The total quantity of fuel oil consumed is 3678 multiplied by 263, you get 956280, which is your total cost for the fuel oil. For diesel oil, we get our total figures as 49600. When you add both of these, we get the final bunker cost as 1005880. Now let's look for the other costs which are there in the question. As far as the question is concerned, we've already been given 70,000 for the load port. Discharge port is 180. We do have canal transit, which we have to pay additionally 260,000. And we have insurance premium as 25,000. How did we arrive at the 25,000? Now, if you go back, guys, let's go back to the question. War risk premium is 70 million. And we are supposed to, in order to get this, we need to pay 0.03. If you multiply 0.03 with 70 million, you get 21,000. And when you add 21,000 with 4,000, which is your crew war bonus insurance, the total we get as 25,000. So when you add all of these expenses, we get a total of 535,000. And when you add all the bunker costs along with the other costs, the final total voyage expenses comes out to be 1540880. Now let's come to the voyage comparison. As per the question is given, as I said, we are supposed to carry 248,000. The rate which is given is 20.25. When you multiply this quantity, the gross freight becomes 5022,000. Okay, but the vessel is fixed on WS80. So when you multiply 0.8 with 20.25, you get the rate which the voyage is fixed on is 16.2. When you multiply this cargo with the rate, you get this gross freight. Also, if you read in the question, they have already mentioned a fixed differential. You see this WS80, and they have also asked to add a fixed rate differential, which is 0.23 per metric ton. Now we need to take that into account. So when you add the fixed differential, which is 0.23 multiplied by the cargo, we learned this concept in our previous lecture when we were able to calculate we did some numericals on the world scale. So we need to add this figure, which is 0.23 multiplied by 24800 5704, to this figure, and finally we get our gross freight as 4074640. The commission as per given the question is 2.5. The 2.5% of this amount is 101866. When you subtract the commission from the gross freight, we get the net freight amount. In order to get the gross volume surplus, we need to minus the total voyage expenses with the net freight. It comes out to be 2431894. And in order to get the gross daily, we need to divide this with the total voyage days, which is 64. The running cost given in the question is 10,000. We subtract with the gross daily, we get the net daily. In order to calculate the time charter equivalent, we need to take the gross freight minus the total voyage expenses divided by 64 days. And we finally get the time charter equivalent with this, which is our 39590. And this is how the whole voyage estimate form looks like. With this, guys, I finish off my lecture number 13. I hope you liked it. Thank you.
Since we have finished this lecture on tanker series, I would like to hear it from you guys. So let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button if you like the video, guys. And remember, one of the most important tips and feedback comes from you. So feel free to connect me on LinkedIn. And thanks for checking out the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. So in this whole chartering series, we have already finished our whole topics. In the next lecture, we'll be focusing on the tips and tricks to clear the ICS exams. Until next time, ShipsCode is bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. Keep on crushing it, and we will talk soon.